Hello everyone. Today's video is about pink eye or conjunctivitis. So pink eye can be caused by multiple things and it's not always bacterial. But most of the time when we say pink eye, we're talking about a bacterial infection of the eye that involves inflammation of that tiny little thin layer called the conjunctiva. So you get it, conjunctivitis, inflammation of the conjunctiva. And we'll often refer to it as the conjunctiva is injected, meaning that the blood vessels in the white part of your eye are very full and just really prominent. And so the eye looks pink or red, the white part of the eye does. So a good rule of thumb for diagnosing pink eye, true pink eye, is that you have two colors. The white of the eye is red and the discharge is more than tears. It's yellow or green and kind of goopy like mucus coming out of the eye, or as a lot of the kids say, eye boogers. So if you have goopy, dry discharge on the eyelashes and the white of the eye is bloodshot, you could have true pink eye. Now remember, other things can mimic this condition like viral conjunctivitis or a foreign body. If a child's been playing in the dirt or sand or had a dirt fight and got a foreign body in its eye, that's important for us to check them out to make sure there's not a corneal abrasion. Also with allergies, children can have pink eyes, but they just have a lot of clear, watery discharge, drainage, and their eyes are extremely itchy, probably have sneezing and runny nose to go along with that. One rule of thumb for us is if the child is under 2 years old with pink eye, they could have an associated ear infection or otitis media. So we'd want them to come in for us to check them out to rule out the ear infection. If they're two and above, this varies with your individual pediatric office, but sometimes, especially in busy winter months, we may be willing to call in the antibiotic eye drops to the pharmacy without seeing the child if they're over two. Now, the most important thing I want to share to you about this with this video today is the easy way to apply eye drops. Like so many things in life, there's an easy way and a hard way. The easy way is you let your child lie down on the couch with its head on your lap, looking up at the ceiling, and then you tell your child to close its eyes. But remember, it's flat back. You put one drop of the antibiotic eye drops in each corner of the eye, if they're both infected, I mean, whichever eye is infected, of course, treat. And there's a naturally occurring little well at the inside corner of each of the eyes beside the bridge of the nose. As long as the child's completely lying back with his eyes towards the ceiling and eyes closed, you can put the drops there and then say, okay, buddy, whenever you're ready, blink your eyes. And then when the child blinks, those eye drops automatically roll into the eye. It's so great. They're pre-warmed before they hit the eye because they've been on the skin. It's just as effective. They don't see you coming at them because their eyes were closed when you placed the drop, so they don't become combative. It's wonderful. The easy way really works once the child's old enough to understand it and can cooperate. Now, there's always gotta be a backup plan, which is the hard way. And the hard way is usually that it takes both parents and one's holding the child down and the other one can pull down one lid and make a little pouch and get one drop in there really quickly. So that's the hard way, but that requires a lot of strength to hold them down and keep their arms down too. Because if they see you coming at them, it's a natural human defensive mechanism to push away and not allow you to do that. Another quick rule for you to remember is the child typically has to be on antibiotic eye drops for 24 hours before returning to school or daycare before they're considered not contagious any longer. So it's my best advice to you is make sure you wash your hands very carefully before placing the antibiotic eye drops to help prevent any further infection in the child, and then wash your hands very carefully after placing the drops so that you don't become infected. It is so simple to touch a surface that the child's touched and then to touch your own eyes, and then that's how you catch pink eye from them. And it is miserable as an adult to have pink eye from your child. It's relatively common. It's easily passed from child to child because it's so easy to touch and then touch a surface and the other child touches their eyes. And that's the reason we want them to stay out until they're no longer contagious before they return to preschool or daycare. Hope that was helpful. Thanks.